please stand for the processional of the graduates. Good afternoon, platform guests, parents, and friends. Welcome to the commencement proceedings of the Carver Magnet High School class of 2022. We ask all who are present to remember that this is a very formal and serious occasion, and your total cooperation is necessary in order to make a very special day for our seniors. Please remain standing for the presentation of the colors, the pledge to our flags, and the singing of the national anthem. Gentlemen, please remove your hats.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. And now for the Texas Pledge. Honor the Texas flag. I pledge allegiance to thee, Texas, one state, under God, one and indivisible.
You may now be seated. The small town of Uvalde was changed forever when the lives of too many were lost to senseless violence earlier this week. The past few days have been some of the darkest and most painful memories for school communities in recent memory. Before we move forward and celebrate what is truly a momentous occasion, let us observe a few moments of silence for those whose lives were taken way too soon and those they've left behind. Thank you. There are a number of individuals who have worked very hard to make this day a special one for you and your graduate. As I introduce the platform guests, please hold your applause until everyone has been introduced. To my right, Dr. Latanya M. Gothney, Superintendent of Schools. Mr. Randy Bates, Jr., School Board President. Dr. Kimberly Booker, Vice President. Ms. Rose Avalos, Secretary. Ms. Connie Esparza, Board Member. Mr. Steve Mead, Board Member. Mr. Paul Shanklin, Board Member. Congresswoman Sheila Jackson Lee. Ms. Shalia Reed, Chief of Staff. Dr. Catherine Rohde, Chief of Schools. Dr. Todd Davis, Chief Academic Officer. Dr. Javier Villarreal. And please pardon my omission, Dr. Viola Garcia, Board Member. Ms. Connie Esparza, Board Member. Dr. Javier Villarreal, Chief Human Resources Officer. Mr. Adam Galvan, Chief Information Officer. Dr. Adrian Bustillos, Chief Transformation Officer. Ms. Dawn Ayers Rodriguez, Chief of Strategic Initiatives and Accountability. M.K. DeWalt, General Counsel. Dr. Soshi Rodriguez, Associate Superintendent of High Schools. To my left, again, Ms. Sheila Jackson Lee, our Congresswoman. Mr. James Shaddle, Assistant Principal for Curriculum and Instruction. Our valedictorian, Amani Turner. Our salutatorian, Sadae Guzman. Our class president, Sir Kristen Turner. Mrs. Ebony Booth Taylor, Assistant Principal. And Mr. Tori Richardson, Assistant Principal. And Mr. Michael Rogers, College Access Advisor. I would also like to recognize other school personnel who may not be on stage but are in the arena. Our high school class sponsors, our high school counselors, and all campus staff who are present. Please give them a round of applause. At this time, I would like to recognize the parents of all graduating seniors and thank each of you for your support you have given your child and to our school. Parents, will you please stand? Thank you. You may be seated. Today, we are honored to have some of our graduating seniors who have enlisted in one of the military branches or who have been accepted into one of the military academies. It is my honor to recognize these students at this time. Graduates who meet this description, please stand and be recognized. We have many students who've worked very hard to earn one or more scholarships. These students are designated in the program with a star. Students, the work you have done to support your education has paid off. If you have earned one or more scholarships, please stand and be recognized. We are proud to report that this class has earned over $2,373,750, and the number is still growing. It is always an honor and pleasure to recognize your moments of celebration. Congratulations again. Now, it is my pleasure to introduce the class of 2022's salutatorian, Sadae Guzman.
Oh my gosh. Hello. Good morning. I'd like to welcome the Board of Trustees, the Superintendent, Dr. Goffney, our Principal, Dr. Robinson, and all other administration, faculty, staff, family, and friends gathered here. And of course, the biggest welcome to George Washington Carver High School's class of 2022 graduates. Woo! My name is Sarai Guzman, and I want to thank everyone here today who has joined us for the long-awaited ceremony we've all dreamed of since the start of our academic journey. To the class of 2022, we made it. Today is an exciting day because we are finally closing this chapter of early mornings, repetitive lunches, and chaotic class transitions. I know these last 4 years have been a wild roller coaster of events that we would have never imagined. From my freshman year of being timid 14, 15-year-olds stepping into a whole new world, to our sophomore year of the COVID pandemic granting us 3 months of spring break, but locking us up at home, to our junior year of phones and computer screens being our new reality, and finally to returning to our senior year to procrastinate and enjoy our last moments of high school. We'll remember the best and the worst of the memories from high school, like the countless tests we hope to pass, whether they were math or COVID tests, the homecoming TikToks you all helped me create, the Lil G performances in the gym, and so much more. Our perseverance and dedication kept us strong to completing our final assignment of high school, walking across this stage. Despite all the odds, we still managed to graduate, so let's give ourselves a big round of applause. Being here in this moment as not only a graduate, but number two in my class, I certainly could not have done without the support of God, of course, my family, friends, and teachers. To my teachers, I want to thank you each for the hard work and commitment you put in for each and every one of us. To all my friends, I am forever thankful for each one of you for helping me create these unforgettable memories throughout my life, from when we were dancing with Miss Alina's to our first to last theater class, to the countless lunches we spent laughing too loud, to today. We've gotten through many ups and downs together, and I believe that each one of us, including everyone sitting down in front of me, are deserving of happiness and success in life. Most importantly, I want to give the biggest thank you to my mom, dad, and sisters who have supported and guided me through these incredible 18 years. You all have pushed me to become the person I am today. Todo lo que he hecho para estar aquí no podría haberlo hecho sin ustedes, y los quiero agradecer por darme todo lo posible en este mundo. To close off, I want to say one final thing. Life is a gift that we only receive once, and in the end, all we have is our memories. Enjoy every moment you spend. Have fun, live your best life, and do it with no regrets. From the bottom of my heart, I wish you all the very, very best. Congratulations again to us, and thank you. And now, it is my pleasure to introduce the class of 2022's valedictorian, Amani Turner.
Good morning, parents, family, friends, teachers, and faculty. I would like to welcome the Aldine Board of Trustees, Superintendent Goffney, and other platform guests. And most importantly, I want to introduce the Carver High School graduating class of 2022. Woo. Before we begin, I would like to thank my parents for supporting me through these 4 years, all of my teachers and mentors for educating me and helping me grow, and every one of you guys for pushing me to become a better person. It is only because of the efforts and attitudes of the people around us that we can succeed. I want to thank all of you for making me the person I am today. And of course, congratulations! Reaching this milestone was a labor of love on each of our parts, and I am unimaginably proud of all of you. I am honored to be able to stand in front of you all today as your valedictorian. We have all put in hundreds of hours of work, stress, and tears into being able to stand in this room and walk across this stage. Today, we will reach a fork in the road of life that will send us in dozens of different directions. This phase of our life is terrifying for all of us. We will no longer have the support systems provided to us by youth. We're entering higher education and the workforce, and that drop into the ocean of adulthood is scary and yet inevitable. Our lives will be changed permanently after today, but that doesn't mean it has to change for the worse. I've had the fortune to meet hundreds of diverse, interesting people in my life, But Carver Panthers have always stood out as the most tenacious, the most passionate, and the most kind-hearted people I've ever met. We have our differences, but we've also stood beside one another through thick and thin. I often compared Carver to other larger high schools. We don't have sports or marching bands, our facilities are a bit small, and our classrooms can either feel empty or claustrophobic. But this tiny school has given me something that no other school could, a community. There's not a single face in this audience that I don't recognize, at least in passing. This is what sets Carver apart from other schools. We're small, but we're close. You're not merely my friend, you're not merely my classmates or my peers, you are all my dear friends. As this day wraps to a close and the summer months begin, I want you all to think back on your time at Carver. We worked hard and we played much harder. We suffered through floods, freezes, and pandemics. We stood out in STEM and the arts, and today we are graduating. Let's keep moving forward with that Carver Panther spirit, and let's each change the world for the better. Thank you.
At this time, I would like to reintroduce Congresswoman Sheila Jackson Lee of the 18th Congressional District, who will make a special presentation.
Let's give our salutatorian and our valedictorian a very big hand. Those are hard jobs. They did an outstanding job. Let me also pay tribute to Dr. Robinson for, again, her passionate leadership for the tiny school that can, the big school that can, George Washington Carver, the pioneering school. Dr. Robinson, thank you so very much. Give her a very big hand, please. Thank you. To all of the staff, the teachers, you are my heroes, and everyone, give a shout out for our teachers and administrators who every day come to work to love your children. Thank you, Superintendent Goffney, for this is a huge system of many, many children from many, many backgrounds. Your guiding hand, steady hand, has shown a very special leadership that I'm so proud of. Your superintendent, give a very loud applause for Dr. Goffney. And where would we be without a committed board of trustees, board of directors for this great school district, our president, Randy Bates? Would you give all of them who are here all the time another big hand? We are in Memorial Weekend, and I cannot be at this podium without acknowledging your family members, even you, graduates, that have served the United States of America. Those who are active duty in the audience or those who are veterans, would you stand up and be honored at this time? Let us see you. Military, veterans. We thank you. Thank you. And to this wonderful class, this class that has the legacy of George Washington Carver, who no one believed in his time could be a creator of massive scientific discoveries. A peanut? Are you serious? A scientist and a peanut? And so my very brief message to you today is that the legacy that you walk in is a legacy that you will make. For someone will look at you and say your name, and really? And they can do this? Or they are attempting to achieve this? We are living in some tumultuous times. You're literally mountain climbers. What classes have gone to pandemics that have literally shut down not just your nation, but the world? And here you are, 2022, mountain climbers, travelers on journeys that no one ever could have imagined you would take. And then someone comes and looks and says, really? You want to do this? You want to open a business? You want to be a multiple conglomerate? You want to be a tech magnate? You want to be a wonderful teacher. You want to be a general, a Secretary of the United States Defense, as Secretary General Austin. And I just want you to realize, you tell them where you've come from and what you're made of. You tell them that Dr. Benjamin Mays said that it's about persistence. That's what education gives you the ability to do. And these are times that cause me, someone who has served in the most powerful organization in the world, the United States Congress, with all of its challenges, to be humbled by the tragedy in Uvalde, to be speechless, to care for those who now have this bottomless pit in their heart. And so I ask you to go forth with persistence, the determination that when someone doubts you, tell them where you're from, George Washington Carver, the man with a peanut who others thought could not do much. And so nothing should distract you, deter you from where you are going. And then, how can anyone who has a motto that ends by saying, reach for our better tomorrows, can do anything but succeed? And so I just close by challenging you. And this time I'm going to ask this class of 2022 in one of the best high schools in the United States of America to stand up if you are willing to accept my challenge of your persistence, your determination, but that you will be a change agent. Is there someone in this class, George Washington Carver 2022, that is going to be a change agent? Congratulations to you. Congratulations to all the class officers that have served with our president, because you have begun your civic engagement, and God bless the United States of America. Thank you, change agents. Congratulations to all of you. Let me ask to represent the class for this special honor from the United States Congress, where it begins by saying, I hereby honor and commend. Would valedictorian Amani Turner come up? She did a great job. Let her come on up now. Salutatorian Sari Guzman, she did a great job. And Clarissa Luna, are you in the audience? Come on down. Come on up. All right. And Amy Mercado, would you come on to represent your class?
Let's give these students and Congresswoman another round of applause. Each one of you will receive a commendation from the U.S. Congress. Greetings to the Aldine ISD Board of Trustees, Superintendent Goffney, platform guests, family, friends, and the persons of the hour, the graduating class of 2022. I stand here with a heart full of gratitude as the principal who arrived and escorted you back into the school building post-pandemic, and now I will escort you across the finish line of your high school career. Your tenacity, Hard work and perseverance paid off, and now we are here, graduation day. For many of you, this is a day full of celebration and excitement for the next stages of your life. For some of you, this day brings some thoughts of uncertainty and maybe even a little stress. For others of you, this day reminds you of the people who began the journey with you and may no longer be here to support you. Some of you may have experienced a loss that you feel is so deep that you cannot recover. Today, this message is for all of you. This is your day. This is your moment. This is your time. Here are a few reminders to help you continue into the next stage of your life. Number one, live each day with courage. Courage, according to dictionary.com, is defined as the quality of mind and spirit that enables a person to face difficulty, danger, or pain without fear. Bravery. As you enter into your new experiences, whatever they are, face them with the roots that you have learned throughout the years. Lean on your convictions and know that you are equipped to handle anything life throws your way. Number two, when you make a promise, keep it. Your word is bond and your reputation is all you have. The first promise to make and keep is the one to yourself. My simple promise to myself every morning is that I'm going to be a better Tracy than I was yesterday. With that promise, I guide my words, my thoughts, and my actions so that I can make good on the promise I make to others. Promise yourself that you will be the best you to yourself, your family, and your future. Number three, remember some things aren't for sale. You'll be tested throughout young adulthood, and you must know what your limits are. Hold steadfast to your beliefs and make sure that your words and your actions match. There's a little gut feeling that we all have. Listen to it and make decisions based on what you know is right and true. As we say in Domino's, all money ain't good money. As you enter into the next stages of your life, I want to encourage you to live each day with courage. When you make a promise, keep it, especially to yourself. And remember that some things aren't for sale. Remember the lessons that were taught about good manners, listening, kindness. Remember that every day is your day, your moment, your time. So as I close, I want to leave you with these wishes. You will be a great blank when you grow up. The blank can only be filled by your hopes and dreams that will guide you. Don't let the little things keep you from your big dreams. Everything always works out. To the class of 2022, thank you for allowing me to serve you, and I look forward to the great futures that you hold. As you told me when I arrived, once a Panther, always a Panther. We are now ready for the presentation of the 2022 graduating class of Carver Magnet High School. Dr. Goffney, will you please join me at the podium? Graduates, will you please stand? Superintendent, I am honored to share with you that these seniors, members of the class of 2022, have met the criteria to graduate. They have satisfied all requirements of Aldine Independent School District and the state of Texas and are hereby entitled to be graduates of Carver Magnet High School with all rights and privileges pertaining thereto.
Students, congratulations. Today is a day that you will always remember. I encourage you to cherish this moment in time. It is such a special time, a time that you can celebrate your accomplishments. Parents, families, teachers, you too should be proud. The support you've provided along the way is what has helped our graduates reach their academic goals. I encourage you to extend that support as they move on to the next chapter of their lives. President Bates, and members of the Aldine Independent School District Board of Trustees, I certify that the students who have met the requirements of graduation set forth by the Texas Education Agency and the Aldine Independent School District Board of Trustees are eligible to receive their diplomas. They shall have all the rights and privileges associated with a Texas high school diploma.
Graduates, you may be seated. The format for awarding diplomas to our graduates enables us to focus more individual attention on each member of the class of 2022 by allowing you to share in the recognition of the honors bestowed upon each of them. The first 23 students represent the top 15% of their class and are listed in the program as graduating magna cum laude with great honors, or cum laude with honors respectively. They will march across the stage in order of their class rank. The first 8 students wear double gold cords to signify their magna cum laude status. The next 15 students will be wearing single gold cord, signifying their cum laude status. You will notice that many of the graduates are wearing different color cords on their graduation gowns. The white sash and blue and gold cords indicate membership in the National Honor Society. All other cords indicate either membership in an organization, outstanding participation in a special program, or academic excellence. Students designated as a foundation with endorsement plan graduate have completed specific curriculum requirements established by the state of Texas. As a reminder to our audience, please refrain from any action that may cause a student's name not to be heard when it is read. Remember, this is a formal occasion. Will the first row of graduates please stand? The graduates will now come forward to receive their diplomas. Mr. Michael Rogers will call the names of the graduating class, and members of the Board of Trustees will present your diplomas.
Amani Love Turner. Sarai Esmeralda Guzman. Pedro Maya. Patricia Marie Ozini. Jordan Christopher Nelson. Danceli Ezequiel Elceda Morales. Emma Simplicia Montiel. Daisy Espinosa. Sir Christian Edward Turner. Alessandra Nicole Isan Wolf. Eric Sanchez Morales. Jalen Aaliyah Lane. Nancy Garcia. Sir Chris John Edward Turner. Alvaro Luis Arteaga Jr. Henry Martinez. Salma Lisette Davila. Courtney Alexis Frazier. Mary Grace Riascos. Christian Daniel Benavides. Serenity Grace Kane. Chloe Madison Kane. Eric Garcia. Justice Oluwafemi Abusanu. Victor Manuel Aguilar. Jose Santiago Aguilar Torres. Sonia Aguirre. Jose Gael Amaya. Jocelyn Arias. Kilar Jose Arriata. Jennifer Barrera Arteaga. Brandon Kai Baxter. Gianna Mawusi Yvonne Benjamin. LaShawn Tyrone Bolton Jr. Keyshawn John Bonner. Cameron Jermaine Bosley. Kavion Javar Brantley. Carrington Wynn Bryce. Christian Xavier Brees. Jaden Marcel Brown. Ariel Janae Burden. Harvey Jared Calles. Jacqueline Lynette Cardenas. Sinai Kai Caraway. Jalen Omari Caston. Juan Pablo Cedillo. Omar Isaú Cel. Giselle Cerda. Samira Cervantes Dorantes. Joel Charqueno Avila Jr. Gregory Jamel Cochran. Aaliyah Chanel Cook. Niambria Tylerica Corbin. Isai Coronado. Carlos Omar Cortes Jr. Alexander Sione Crooks. Alexandra Diaz. Elizabeth Noemi Diaz. Sydney Lauren Durden. America Noemi Flores. Siobhan Deshaun Foreman. Reginald Riddell Franklin. Christopher Dwayne Jordan Freeman. Israel Alberto Garcia. Geronimo Emiliani Garcia. Xavier Galindo Garcia. Nicholas Grant Gatson. Curtis Gibson IV. Hector Daniel Gonzalez. Melanie Gonzalez. Victoria Gonzalez. Jamon Joseph Gordwin. Erin Lynette O'Neill Graves. Nicole Araceli Gutierrez. Joshua Previn Handy. Courtney Rochelle Hernandez. Linaya Renee House. Deshandra Monet Jackson. Ashlyn Riley Jacobs. Jamarce Keon Johnson. Xavion Deshane Johnson. Zacharias Ezekiel Johnson. Aaliyah Joyce Lynn Jones. Brendan Bernard Jones. Jaden Khalil Jones. Marcus Christopher Jordan. Quincy John Kimani. Cherish LaShawn Kennedy. Caleb Renee Lacey. Tyreek Lamont. Jonathan Isaac Lara Masferrer. Aubrey Lavelle Lee. Ruben DeAngelo Lopez. Devin Lester Love. Clarissa Luna. Christian Orlando Manzano. Lilette Kiana Martinez. Brinaya Denae Mason. Ronnie O'Brien Membreno, Allison Nicole Mendez, Amy Mercado, Anthony Jermaine Milburn Jr., Denise Frenesi Miranda, Aldo Jonathan Mondragon Vargas, Christina Alexandria Montgomery, Devin Danae Moore, Angie Taranara Moreno, Courtney Denise Neal, Nadia Simone Noble, Crystal Anai Olivares, Cameron Woodrow Phillips, Jaquille Ivante Earl Poole, Preston Maxwell Porter, Gabrielle Avante Powell, Giselle Ramos, Andres Rico, Darius Jalen Robinson, Mike Kaleon Kivante Robinson, Natalia Patricia Rodriguez, Bryant Rodriguez, Candelaria Rodriguez, Elijah James Ruckett, Andrew Salazar, Angel Gabriel Salazar, Andres Saldana Sorto, Jose Luis Sanchez, Saul Sanchez, Kennedy Simone Smith, Keith David Raul Tay, Gabriel Raheem Turner, Carlos Alberto Vasquez, Santiago Enrique Vera Ramirez, Brooke Lynn Walsh, Cadence Summer Weathersby, Ariana Simone White, Dejanay Dion Williams, Danielle Jayon Turkett, Cheyenne Marie Willis Bumper, Quinte Renee Wilson, Johnny Brent Wright III, Margaret Nicole Wilson, Emmanuel Ray Yerling, Liani Noemi Zepeda, Keyshawn Williams,
Graduates, will you please stand? Please move your... Please move your tassels from the right to the left side of your cap, symbolic of your graduation. I proudly present the Carver Magnet High School graduating class of 2022. Congratulations. A reminder to the audience that you must exit At the rear of the arena, please stand for the school song and remain standing until the graduates have recessed.
Thank you.